Today's iris, some of my favorite iris fragrances. Welcome to the channel where fashion needs fragrance. My name is Kevin Samuels, your godfather of style. And guys, in today's video, we're going to talk about one of my favorite fragrance notes and some of those fragrances. If you like this kind of video, cool. Go ahead and subscribe and drop a like down below. Shout out to the CIA. Gentlemen, how are you doing today? You all know by now my favorite fragrance notes are rose, amber, oud. You also know I dig incense, patchouli, iris, and honey. And today I want to focus on some of my favorite iris fragrances. Now, before we get into this, understand there are plenty of iris fragrances out there to choose from. But I like my iris to be a certain kind of way. I don't like it overly powdery. I like it to lean a little bit more sophisticated, to have a little bit of class, refinement. You know how we do. An iris fragrance that not only gets noticed, is signature scent worthy. That being said, let's get into the video. Shout out to the CIA. One love, FBI. If you want to become part of the movement, make sure you join me on Patreon for exclusive video and live stream content. Join me on that platform for things you will only see there. Details down in the description. First up on the list, we have none other than Prada L'Homme. Prada L'Homme, guys, is a simple, clean, dumb-reach iris fragrance. This is a great office-based iris fragrance that I think belongs in almost any gentleman's wardrobe. Dior Homme Eau is also a great alternative, but honestly, I think Prada L'Homme did it better for most guys. For most guys, and it fits the Prada spot. Prada L'Homme starts my list off right. Since I already talked about Dior, let's go with Dior Homme. You know how I feel about this fragrance. Love it, can't get enough of it. Honestly, I think it is criminally underrated in the fragrance community, and Dior Homme is the fragrance line that's based all around the iris. DHS, Dior Homme Sport, actually is based around iris, but in 2017, they pulled that note out, put in blood orange. So if you get anything before 2017, it's an iris-based fragrance also. So many in this collection, but this one right here, takes the cake for me and will always be in my collection. Dior Homme Iris Masterpiece. Next up from the house of Serge Lutton, we have Cher Guy. This is a tobacco iris fragrance, but for me, the iris done in here is just so masculine, so good. And I love to wear this on a warm summer evening because it catches the wind and cooks so good on my skin. Cher Guy, if you haven't smelled it, do yourself a favor, put your nose on it, just test it. Test it, try it, you might love it, then buy it. Serge Lutton, Cher Guy, heavenly fragrance. What iris list would be complete without Valentino Uomo Intense? Now, sure, Dior Homme Intense, I dig that overall, but for the iris note, this does much more for the iris. Dior Homme Intense has much more of that, has much more of the cacao sweetness. Valentino Uomo Intense, in my opinion, is a masterful creation and a great representation for a romantic, sexy iris fragrance that I think you need in your collection, especially if you love iris. Next up from Conor Barcelona, we have D600. Yes, D600, and this is one a lot of people don't know much about. Think of Dior Homme, but actually amp up the iris note and make it a little bit more sophisticated. This stuff is cool in a bottle. Cool in a bottle and a great iris fragrance, especially as we transition into fall and winter. This will be one, if you're an iris lover, you definitely want to think about adding to your collection because it smells fantastic and it smells familiar like Dior Homme, but it is very different. And so don't think you need one instead of the other. Both are great in the collection. Conor Barcelona D600 Iris Goodness. Next up in the Dior line, we have Bois d'Argent. In my opinion, a signature fragrance that lasts all year round. This gets a lot of talk in the fragrance community. Some people prefer it in the warmer months, some people prefer it in the cooler months. Me, I just prefer it all year round. If you want to smell niche in the office, this is it. If you want to graduate from Prada L'Homme and smell a little bit more upscale, that's this fragrance right here. Bois d'Argent, fantastic fragrance and a great blending fragrance if you like to mix and match. Me, I'm a purist. I tend to prefer letting things be what they are. And this is one that's so good, I just let it do what it does. Next up from the house of Chanel, we have 31 Rue Cambon. Yep, 31 Rue Cambon. The iris note in this fragrance is one that many people tend to overlook. One, because the Chanel exclusives are so hard to get your nose on. Two, because it actually comes out in the mid. For me, it's a very noticeable iris and a completely different take on it. This fragrance, in my opinion, is refined sophistication at its best. Chanel does fragrances right. 31 Rue Cambon is definitely one you need to put your nose on, try if you're an iris lover. Also, you'll have the uniqueness factor because not a lot of people wear it. From next one, I'm gonna go over real quick, YSL Trench. Why am I going over that one quickly? Because I'm out of it now. Just used the last little bit of it 2 weeks ago, had to order me another bottle. Trench is a great iris fragrance, especially for the warmer weather. Trench is one you definitely need to put your nose on if you're an iris lover and you kind of lean much more towards that clean, office-friendly version of iris. But I gotta tell you, on the top of my list for iris, I love Florentine Iris from Zegna. From the first time I smelled this fragrance, I was transported. I was hooked. And I'm surprised more people don't talk about this. So good, so sophisticated. It's a manly take on iris that just, in my opinion, is masterful. Now, the only downside for me, it is an eau de toilette. And honestly, I think too many people look past Zegna because they released everything in one shot. People kind of gravitated towards the ones they like, and it tended to be the fresher ones. But this one, in my opinion, masterpiece. Masterful fragrance, my favorite iris fragrance, and one I will always have in my collection. And I'm so glad that in their fragrance reduction or trimming their line down, that they didn't take it off the market. Gentlemen, there you have it, my favorite iris-based fragrances. Do me a favor, let me know what your favorite iris fragrances are down in the comment section. Did you like my choices? Have you smelled them? Did you like them? If so, cool. If not, cool. But keep it cool, keep it classy. As usual, if you like this kind of video, share it out to anybody that you think can use the information. Thanks for watching. Thanks for subscribing. Until next time, talk to you later. Godfather of Style, out. Hey guys, whether look, style, or life, whether personal or professional, you can level up and be your personal best each and every day. If you're interested in any of that, do us both a favor. Follow the link in the description and book your one-on-one session with me. Details down in the description. Peace.